Yo, what is up, guys? I hope you guys are having a great day. And we are back today with something a little different, still small engine related, but nothing like this before. But before we get started, definitely go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you like this video, definitely go ahead and like it, please. It helps me out a lot. So let me show you guys what we have.
All right, so this is what we have for today's project. It is a 10 horsepower generator, Dayton Professional industrial power plant. I'm not sure, I'm not quite sure what model or anything this thing is, but all I know, 10 horsepower, four stroke. This thing is pretty old, I'm guessing. As you can just look at it, but I have high hopes that it will start. The gas tank, if you look inside of it, I don't know if you're gonna be able to see anything. Yeah, you can't really see anything, but it does look pretty clean in there, so that's really good. The oil looks good. I checked the oil. I'm probably still gonna do an oil change. But I think our first step is to go ahead and pull off this carburetor. I've never worked on a updraft carburetor, I believe this thing is called, so that'll definitely be interesting. So yeah, let's go ahead and start by popping off this carburetor. Go ahead and start by taking off this air filter, see how that looks. So it has an air filter, that's good. Take out this whole thing. All right, looking in the air intake. Yeah, as you can see, it looks pretty good. Now that I got a light, I'll show you the gas tank. And honestly, for how long this thing has been sitting, it looks pretty good. So that's really good. But yeah, so I'm not too worried about having to do too much cleaning, but I just want to go ahead and pop this carb off just to make sure everything's 100%. So yeah, let's do it. All right, so now we have the updraft carb up on the workbench, and this thing is pretty massive as compared to my hand. Yeah, this thing is pretty huge. But it does appear the throttle is stuck. I can't move that. I know on generators like it's supposed to be at like a certain RPM, so maybe I should just leave it like that. May have to get another fuel filter. I believe that's what this is. Maybe, I don't know, maybe just blow it out. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and start cracking this thing open. So I believe you have to take out this is a needle. You have to take out this before you can take the top off. So yeah, let's just get right to it. So we just pulled out this long needle. This is what I was talking about. And I heard that you definitely want to make sure that whatever flathead you're using fits really well in this, because it is a lot easier to strip than some other ones. So yeah, just caution on that. Yeah, everything's looking pretty good so far. Definitely dirty, so I'm glad I'm cleaning it. But yeah, now we'll go ahead and pop off these four flathead screws or bolts, and then yeah, we'll see what it looks like. Here's what it looks like inside. Not too bad, actually. I don't know, they must have ran it out of gas or used some like ethanol free gas, or some like fuel preserver, I'm not sure, but actually looks pretty good. Float side looks pretty good as well, honestly, not too much crap. But yeah, we'll just go ahead and clean it up really good, and then throw it all back together. So let's do it. So I was trying to reuse this gasket, and yeah, as you can see, this thing is just trashed, so that's really not good. Yeah, I'm gonna have some gasket material, and this will be a hard one to recreate, but yeah, I guess I gotta do what I gotta do. So yeah, let's get it. So I just cut out this little gasket. Should work, who knows. But yeah, so now we're gonna go ahead and throw it back together. So let's do it. All right, carb is clean and ready to be thrown back on. So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and put this back on and then probably wash out the gas tank, and then we'll see if this thing will start up. Alright, so now that we got the carb mostly on, now I'm going to go ahead and pull the spark plug, probably put some oil down the cylinders, and then test for sparks. So yeah, see. So as you saw, it does have sparks, so now we're going to go in and clean out this gas tank. Probably just pour some diesel or maybe even just gas down there, and shake it around because it wasn't too dirty, and then we'll let it drain out, and then we'll put some fresh ones in, and then see if this thing will fire up. Alright, so I did a couple more things. I replaced the fuel line, fuel filter, cleaned out the gas tank a little bit. So I put a little bit of fuel in there, so that should be good to go. Yeah, check the oil like I said before, and yeah, I think it's ready to start up, so we'll give it a shot. Let's see what it does. Take a So yeah, as you guys saw, this thing runs great. It started up a second pull, and then I had to do a little bit of a j adjustment on it. But yeah, it runs great. The generator part works awesome. As you saw, I hooked up the angle grinder to it and worked no problem. So yeah, so I just turned the field cock, or the pet cock, whatever. I just turned that off, ran it out, so should be ready to go next time I need it. But yeah, that'll be good for right now.
All right, guys, that's gonna be a wrap for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. And if you guys enjoyed this video, definitely go ahead and give it a thumbs up and even hit that subscribe button too. It really helps me out. So, yeah, thank you guys so much for watching.